Nothing new for me. Me. Nothing's worrying me. Oh, that's right. That's right. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. It's your guy, Rodney G, and welcome to the Pigeon Academy Show. We are here this beautiful rainy day in the NYC. We are here. We're going to be talking some bird stuff right off the bat. What's good, John Jay from California, from Cali, one of the roller men, one of the top roller guys from California. Good afternoon, John Jay. What's good? Give me a shout out here, Jay. I'm going to be doing a little show here today. Top of the afternoon to you. Top of the morning to you. What's good? We were playing some of our favorite music there because it is raining cats and dogs here in the NYC. It is raining cats and dogs. I'm going to be bringing up some stuff today. Got an interesting afternoon ahead of us, and I'm going to be putting up some stuff here and doing some promotions today and just talking some bird stuff. Talking some bird stuff and having some fun doing that. That's what we do here at the Pigeon Academy. So I want to bring up one of these videos right off the bat. I want to get this cracking. And I want to support these brothers for what they did. Let's see here. Let's see if we can get this up here. And I'm going to take one of these down. Let's see what we got here. So, John Jay, what's cracking, man? What's good? What's going on, man? How's the weather out there? How's the weather out there in beautiful California? How's it going out there? I'm going to bring up a video here. Let me tell you, we had a very good conversation the other night. I'm going to just write testing 1, 2, 3. Always got to be testing out my comms. That's what we do here. For the fanciers here, let's see, am I coming up? I got my cell phone out also to see if we are coming up. Testing 1, 2, 3. Okay. I'm going to bring up a video here, a trailer to Pigeon Kings. We were online the other night with one of the players, one of the top players in the movie, which was Keith London. So I'm going to bring up their trailer here, and we're going to go right at that, and let's see if we can check this out real quick. Let's see. And this is the trailer for Pigeon Kings. Thank you. I checked that out the other night, man. That was pretty good, man. I was checking it out. I was just laying in the cut, taking a look at that. Let me tell you, the weather got the comms acting a little crazy today, but it's all good. So let me see here. I want to make sure I'm not infringing and that we are putting out the right intel. So yes, we are here. I see there's several guys here. Guys, those of you that are watching the Pigeon Academy show this afternoon, hit us in the comments, man. Say hello to us so we can hit you back. Let me see if we can bring John Jay up here. John Jay, this was John Jay's comment. He gave us the, gave us that. That's that Cali San Jay. That's that stuff. That's what's up. Peter Foreman, good day from South Australia. Let's bring that up. There we go. Australia is in the house. What's good, Peter? What's going on? Welcome to the Pigeon Academy show all the way from Australia. That's what's up. I know you guys out in Australia are some avid pigeon guys. And that's what's up, man. I know you guys are into racing, tippler pigeons. Are you guys, Peter, are you guys into the roller pigeons out in Australia? Tell me what's going on. Are you guys into the roller pigeons out in Australia? We just were promoting Pigeon Kings, and that is a film that they did. Keith London was the main principal in that film. You can go to iTunes, you can go to Amazon, and you could pick that up. You could purchase it, or you could rent it. This is the Pigeon Academy doing what we do. We do collaborations with many fanciers. I'm going to be doing some shout-outs. I got a list here this morning. I'm going to be doing a shout-out to some people that I want them to contact me. Feathers Elite. Feathers Elite. Get in contact with me. Feathers Elite, holla back at us. Holla back at us, Feathers Elite. We want to hear from you guys. A lot of you guys that we're going to be doing a lot of collaborations coming up. Oliver Henderson, we're going to be doing something with Danny. We're going to be doing another project, a really nice one-loft racing project we're getting ready to do with Warren. I want to make sure I say his last name right. And we got a lot of projects coming up. Those of you that want to do some collabs, those of you that want to be a part of the show, come on, man, bring it on, because we're going to be bringing a whole bunch of stuff. What's good, Edwin? What's going on? Where are you at? I see your comment here on my cell phone. I'm waiting for you to come up here in your box. Edwin is watching. What's good, brother? Edwin throws an outstanding pigeon auction out in New Jersey. So those of you that are here, we're doing roll call. Bring up your comments. Say what's up. And bring up all that good stuff. Let's see here. We got a Baron. Am I saying it right? Baron from New Jersey. Flying Racing Pigeons. That's what's up, man. There you go. Big. Excuse me. Big Racing Pigeon Circuit out in New Jersey. Shout out to the Jersey Flyers out in New Jersey. B, what is the biggest race? What is the biggest race? So now I'm going to have two questions out there. What is the biggest pigeon race in the state of New Jersey? What is you guys' biggest race? Club, one-off? What is the biggest race being hosted? So I got two questions out there. I got one for Peter, which is, do they fly roller pigeons in Australia? And the other question is for a Baron, which is, what is you guys' biggest race in the state of New Jersey? You know I'm your host, Rodney G of the Pigeon Academy Show. We are here today. It is a rainy Friday morning, and it is nasty out, man. I mean, my goodness. You know? My goodness, man. We're gonna be shouting out everybody. Okay. So, B, I see your comment here. I'm gonna bring it up. South Jersey Combine. But what is the biggest race? What is you guys' biggest race? Or am I asking a question properly? Just correct me if I'm not. I'm open for correction. Like here in New York, we have two big races. I think they're kind of neck and neck. And that those races are the World Trade Center race, held by the Bronx Club. And the LBRA Club, a race, which is an auction race, a band race, I believe, I'm saying it right. And those are the two biggest races here, the LBRA and the World Trade Center race. We collabed on both of those. We helped promote those. Oh, a friend of mine, Skyscraper Loft, he was doing a lot of that. So, you know, we here doing roll call, welcoming all the guys. What's good, Kevin? What's good, Alex? What's good? Alex, what's up, brother? We doing roll call here. We got all the fanciest here. We shouting out everybody out. Everybody that comes on, man, put something in the comments, man. Say something so I could bring your tag up, because that's what that is right there. That's your tag. Excuse me. So bring a tag up. World Trade Center. All right, this was Barron's. He said he flies the World Trade Center and the bar. The LB, is that the LBAR? LBAR, right? Okay. So you guys flying all of those races out there in Jersey, huh? You must be in a good position. Yeah. I know about the Central Jersey Combine. You know, a lot of good fanciers out in Jersey, man. East Coast is flooded with a lot of good racers out there, man. You know? I would want to ask this question. I'm gonna ask it. I might as well. Who is the top pigeon racer? I'm talking wins by wins in Jersey. Who is the top winning club fancier in the state of New Jersey? Good question. Good question. Good question, Rodney G. Like there's a lot of guys here. The Big Apple. Okay, here you go, Baron. He's putting it out there. There you go, brother. He said Big Apple race. The Big Apple race is thrown by the New Rochelle Club and Bobby Waters Club, right? Yeah, that's a big race. Yeah, there's some K, there's some points on that. Yeah, there's some points on that. Shout out to Jose Reyes. What's up, Reyes? Welcome to the Pigeon Academy Show. We're doing roll call this morning. You know. So, Peter says I'm going to bring your comment up here, Peter. We asked Peter, and here's Peter's comment. The question I asked Peter was, "Do they fly roller pigeons in Australia?" And he says, "I'm not sure about rollers. I was into racing pigeons before I got pigeon lung." Oh yeah. So you retired now, huh? Yeah, that pigeon lung. That pigeon lung is strong, man. Yeah, pigeon lung is strong. And you got to be careful now, especially now. Anything respiratory now is like, whoo, you got to be careful. I suffered a little bit because I'm allergic. And I suffered a little bit of a couple of years ago. I suffered some allergic reactions from having my birds myself, you know? So it's crazy. Big Apple race. And Bant B said, he said a comment. No comment. Was that pertaining to the Big Apple race, B? We ask questions here. For those of you that are joining us here, you're watching the Pigeon Academy show. I'm your host, Rodney G. You're watching the number one leading pigeon show coming out of the United States. You're here at the number one pigeon show leading coming out of the United States. I see your comment, Alex. I'm going to bring your comment up here. This is what Alex says. Salute, Rodney Petty. We fly the Triple Crown in Massachusetts. There we go. The EGM auction, T-band auction, and the S-band auction. All 300 miles. There we go. There we go. That's what's up. There you go, Alex. I like that. Yeah, man. And let me say this. I'm going to say this like I said the other night. Promote those things. Each one of those races. Promote those races on Instagram. Promote them races to Facebook. Promote them to YouTube. Promote them races to LinkedIn. Because all these races, not saying these particular races, I'm saying all these races in general, they're suffering from one thing. They're suffering from one thing, obscurity. Meaning, people don't know about those races. There might be 500 capacity, right? They might be like, okay, there's 500 pigeons that can fit in the loft. And they might get 500 pigeons. And they'd be like, yo, we're satisfied with that. What about other fanciers that might want to come in? That would eliminate some guys being like, oh, look, you racing this race all the time. Instead of you sending 10 birds, you're only going to be able to send 7 birds because we have 20 new fanciers. It's all about opportunity. It's all about opportunity. And here's Stratford. Stratford asked this question. Are the pigeon wars still going on in New York City? That's a good question. That's a good question, Stratford. Stranford, right? Stranford, I'm going to say this to you. Check out our page, the Pigeon Stock Banging page. All right, I'm going to put it in here for you. Pigeon Stock Banging page. This is a page that your guy, Rodney G, created to display the pigeon wars that's going on, that's still going on in New York. I've put a lot of content up there. I am an active stock banger or pigeon wars guy. I'm active when it comes to that. I got a team of tipplers. Excuse me. I say it's about 45 tipplers that I have in my backyard loft. And we are, there's a, in my 8-mile radius, there's about 10 stocks. Stranford, and I'm competing against those guys, and we're playing catch keep. And it is, last year it was fantastic. If you go on there, you will be entertained. You have to become a guest to see those images. And the page is called Pigeon Stock Banging Page, and all the videos there are only about pigeon stock banging here in New York City. But let me say this. Stranford, have you, just answer me in the comments. Have you ever seen that video with them doing stock banging in Egypt? Have you ever seen that? Man, check that out. Go to YouTube and look up Pigeon Wars in Egypt. And watch that video that they put out there. They got a heavy pigeon wars culture in Egypt, man. I see you said you were going to check it out. Yeah, man. Yeah, love them. Listen, I love me some pigeon stock banging, man. Love it. I wake up being ready to go do some pigeon stock banging, man. Love it. There it is there. That's the name of the page. Pigeon stock banging. And let me tell you go there, you're gonna be entertained. You're gonna be entertained. Yeah. You gotta check that. So go check that video out on in Egypt. You're gonna be like, oh, I love it. I love it. I love it. I wanna bring up something here. All right, I want to take this down and I want to go to a quick commercial break and I want to give this tribute to one of the fanciers that passed away just over a year and a half and some change ago. And this was Johan. He was over in Europe and he used to do a lot of stuff for us. And he used to do some fantastic videos. A lot of you fanciers know him. I'm going to play one of his videos, and a lot of you got his work. This is my tribute to him. I was thinking about him, and I was just thinking about him, and I was like, I want to do a tribute to him on any one of my next shows. And this is to you, brother Johan. Rest in peace. This is my tribute to you, my friend. Yeah, that's what's up, man. That was Johan's work. Shout out to Johan, man. Beautiful fancier. He passed some time ago, man. Shout out to him and his family. Bless them. And we're doing some stuff today. Welcome to the Pigeon Academy show. I want to bring up this comment that a Baron made right here. And he says, I'm inviting everyone who is flying World Trade Center in Big Apple to join the 250 mile QCM for preparation for Big Apple and World Trade Center. Baron, if you can, man, put us a link up in there. Put us a link up in there so when the guys go back and see the rebroadcast, they can see your comments. We are always interacting with our guests here at the Pigeon Academy show. We are very active. We are hoping everything goes well. Unfortunately for myself, I'm not going to be able to race this year with a lot of my family and friends being unemployed. That unemployment is not going to last forever. So I'm taking money that I have to allocate to my good friends and family. I'm going to be making donations and making sure they're right. And I'm actually going to take this year off. And that is my current situation. I'm also a member of the New Rochelle Club, so that's what we're doing. And we're going to move forward. We're going to stay positive, but unfortunately, that is my story. But thank you for that, Baron. Let's see if we can get these guys to collab with you and put that out there. That's a good thing. This is why we do the Academy. We love putting all this information out. I want to share this one video with you that was sent to me from one of the top pigeon fanciers. One of the top pigeon fanciers sent me this video. And guys, unfortunately, it's not in English. But enjoy it anyway.
Su ih nekad nazivali, tisućama godina koristili su se za brzo i sigurno prenošenje poruka na velike udaljenosti. Sudjelovali su u ratovima, čak postoji priča o tome da su krijumčarili drogu, no danas imaju potpuno drukčiju ulogu. Jedan od najboljih uzgajivača golubova listonoša u Hrvatskoj je Mario Laketa iz Koprivničkih Bregi. Njegovi golubovi prelaze stotine kilometara u utrkama preko cijele Europe, a donijeli su mu na desetke trofeja. Riječ je o pticama fascinantnih sposobnosti, brzine i orijentacije, koje ni dan danas znanstvenici nisu uspjeli objasniti. Sigurno je jedino da se iz bilo koje točke na zemlji uvijek vraćaju svojoj kući. Na utrkama tisuće golubova juri više od 100 km na sat, a i samo sekunde znaju odlučivati o pobjedniku. Oni najbolji su iznimno cijenjeni. Najskuplji golub prodan je u Kini za 500.000 eura, a u Europi je najviša cijena bila u Nizozemskoj, 210.000 eura. Selekcija i treniranje vrlo su strog proces, ali zdravlje goluba je najvažnije. Kako kaže naš uzgajivač, i prosječan golub ako je zdrav, može napraviti dobar rezultat.
That was a video by Mario Laketa. Unfortunately, it's not in English. I'm working on that video to translate it and put it on my Pigeon Academy show on YouTube. So hopefully you guys will get a chance to see that and what he's talking about. Outstanding pigeons. That was Mario Laketa and our collaboration that we did with him where he sent us a video. Unfortunately, Mario does, again, he doesn't speak English. But we will be putting that up and so forth. Here's another comment from Baron, and this is what he says. It's another comment here. I already put this one up. It's another one. And he's talking about you guys participating. Go to the CJC Combine website, and all the special races in New Jersey are there. Thank you for the heads up on that. I'm going to definitely make a footnote on that. And I want to bring up this. Some race results here. This was Gable Sanchez winning first place at the Big Andy's race this year. And this is his video here, okay? And Gable Sanchez, reach out to us here at the Pigeon Academy. And this is his video here. And this is his pigeon that won first place in the Big Andy's a World Invitational Race.
It's the first, el primer lugar de la carrera de hoy, el Big Andy.
Enseña la sala ahí como se ve. Tremendo cuido, tremenda salud los animales, una recuperación increíble, increíble. Tremendas condiciones tiene esa paloma. Mira para allá. Parece que ni voló. Felicidades, Giovanni. Hermanazo, una vez más, Mr. 400.
That was Gable Sanchez and his winning bird for the Big Andy's race. Guy won first place. Reach out to us for an interview, Gable. I want to welcome Troy Spencer to the show. Good, what's up, Troy? Troy from Canada. What's good, Troy? I see you over there, Troy. What's going on? We here at the Academy kicking a little something, something. Shout out to Troy. Welcome, Troy Spencer. Pigeon Academy show saying, good morning, Troy. We here. We talking about all kind of things. We covering Mario Laketa. We covering the shout outs. We covering Johan's work that he did. Feathers Elite reaching out to you guys. We're going to be trying to do a really nice collaboration with the Peach Classic, a collaboration with the Hoosier Race, and we're going to be trying to do a really nice collaboration with the Southern Belle Race in Georgia. So we got a lot of things that we are plugging into, and we will be putting together, and it will be some great pigeon entertainment for you and yours. You know we're dealing with this coronavirus. A lot of us are still on lockdown. They are talking about opening up all kind of things and getting back to business. All I'm going to say to that is, no matter where you are and they open back up, be diligent in wearing your protection. Be diligent in wearing your protective gear, your mask. Be diligent in working out. Working on your cardiovascular. Be diligent on wearing your gloves. Be diligent on your social distancing. And then above all, if you don't have to go to the hospital, don't stay out of the zone if you don't have to. But use all your social distancing and the whole nine yards. We just wanted to bring a little bit of energy to you guys today. We are coming to you live from New York. It's a rainy day. It's a rainy day in New York today, and we're just coming to you today. I want to bring up one of my favorite videos. Let's see if I can bring this video up. This is one of my favorite videos. I'm trying to get this thing to come up. I'm going to bring that down. And this is one of my favorite pigeon videos. I want to play this because it always puts me in the right mood. And this is from David Stevenson. I love this video. It always brings some positive energy. I hope you enjoy it as much as I do.
I'm coming home. I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming.
I'm back where I belong. Yeah, I never felt so strong. Yeah. I'm back, I'm feeling like there's nothing I can't try. And if you with me, put your hands high.
You haven't lost a life before. Hey. This one's for you.
Me, put your hands high.
The dreams are filled. You're rocking with the best.
Hey.
I'll be on the song.
I hear the tears of a clown. I hate that song. I always feel like they're talking to me when it comes on.
Come on.
Another day, another dawn. Another Keisha, nice to meet you, get the math, I'm gone. What am I supposed to do when the club lights come on? It's easy to be puffed, but it's harder to be shown. What if my twins ask me why I ain't married a mom? Damn, how do I respond? What if my son stares with a face like my own and says he wants to be like me when he's grown? Shit, but I ain't finished grown. Another night, the inevitable prolong. Another day, another dawn.
Come on.
Just tell Keisha and Teresa I'll be better in the morning. Another lie that I carry on. I need to get back to the place I belong.
I'm coming home. I'm coming home.
I'm coming home.
Tell the world I'm coming home.
Yeah.
Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday.
Ain't no
I know
man.
My kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes.
Thank you.
I'm coming home.
I'm coming home.
Coming home.
Check this out. A house is not a home. I hate this song. Is a house really a home when your loved ones is gone? And niggas got the nerve to blame you for it. And you know you would've took the bullet if you saw it. But you felt it and still feel it. And money can't make up for it or conceal it. But you deal with it and you keep ballin'. Ross, I'm lickin' Playboy and we keep ballin'. Baby, we've been living in sin, cause we've been really in love, but we've been living as friends.
Yeah.
So you've been a guest in your own home. It's time to make your house your own. Pick up
I'm
the phone.
Coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world that I'm coming home.
Coming home.
Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. And all my kingdom away, and they've forgiven.
Yeah. Oh. Ain't no stopping us now. I love that song. Whenever it comes on, it makes me feel strong. I thought I told you that we won't stop till we back cruising through Harlem. These old blocks is what made me, saved me, drove me crazy, drove me away, then embraced me, forgave me for all of my shortcomings. Welcome to my homecoming. Yeah, it's been a long time coming. A lot of fights, a lot of scars, a lot of bottles, a lot of cars, a lot of ups, a lot of downs. Made it back, lost my dog.
Miss you,
but here I stand, come on, a better man.
Stop.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
Lord. Coming home, oh. Tell the world that I'm coming home.
I'm coming home.
Let the rain wash away.
Feel so
all
good.
The pain of yesterday.
Feel so free.
And know my
ain't no place like
with
home, baby.
And they forgive
me. Ain't no place like home.
Yeah, that's right. Love that video, man. I love that video by David Stevenson. Peter said, great video, Rodney G. We are always here pushing the right energy, man. We are not playing around here at the Academy. It is all about positive pigeon energy. We are hoping that everything goes well, man, and everybody gets a chance to race birds this year, man. You know, one of the things I said that I was going to do for next year is I'm no longer going to race under the banner of the six-stall off. I'm actually going to change my approach, and I'm now going to be racing under the banner of the Pigeon Academy show, excuse me, 6SL. And there's two things I want to do next year, because this year for me, it's a wash for me. I want to train my yearlings that I have for this year for old bird season, okay? And then next spring, come out and race these yearlings as old birds in the old bird season and do it all for development of my bracing program, do it all for the development of fun and cultivating my loft and everything. And the other part I want to do is I want to do one loft racing. So we're going to pick some races next year. And we're going to try to get five birds in each one of those races. And we're going to start at the top. We're going to start with all our races here in the USA. So I'm going to go after the Hoosier, a California Classic, Arizona Classic. I'm going to go after North Carolina Classic. I'm going to go after all those type of races, and the goal is to get five birds into those races and do some one-loft racing, because the young bird season for me here is shot. It's gone. So next year, I want to just do old birds, breed all my young birds for one-loft racing, and then pretty much have the summer off to go play golf, sell some real estate, but, you know, enjoy life and enjoy some family time. Because it's important, even if you're a racer, it's important that I think you sometime take a season. Like maybe you'll take the young bird season off, or maybe you'll take the old bird season off and utilize that time to grow with your family, grow with your children, your spouse, your business. Because a lot of times you've heard the stories. We get so deep. This sport is so addictive that people be like, we haven't gone out to dinner in 30 days. And you were behind those birds all the time. So you got to be mindful. You got to be mindful to keep a nice balance. So that's what I want to do for next year. I want to do old bird racing. And I definitely want to do some one-loft racing. And this year will give me a chance to build more breeders, of my birds that I have in my loft and then go at it from there. But we hopefully we're going to be airing some really nice videos, I say, by 2 o'clock. So look for our post. You've been watching the Pigeon Academy show with your guy, Rodney G. We hope we brought a little energy to you, a little fun, a little creativity, shared some things with you. It's been your guy. Thanks for watching. It's been your guy, Rodney G. Enjoy the rest of the day. Look for our shared post of our videos for my library around 2 o'clock. Later, guys.